I made it through. Spite of the storm and rain, heartache and pain, still I'm declaring I made it through. See, I didn't lose. Experience loss at a major cost, but I never lost faith in you. So if you see me cry, it's just a sign that I'm still alive. Oh yeah, I got some scars, but I'm still alive. In spite of calamity, he still has a plan for me, and it's working for my good, and it's building my testimony.
So glad I made it. I made it through.
In spite of the storm and rain.
In spite of the storm and rain.
Heartache and pain.
I'm still alive, declaring that I made it through.
Experience loss.
Experience loss.
And a major cost.
But I never lost it. I'm so glad I made it.
Is there anybody in here have that testimony?
I made it through.
I made it through.
In spite of the storm.
In spite of the storm. So glad I made it. So glad I made it. I made it through. I made it through.
So glad I made it.
Thank you, Jesus.
So glad I made it.
I could have lost my mind. I could have lost my mind.
I made it through.
But I made it through. You almost threw in the towel.
I made it through.
But when you look back over your life,
I made
you realize I made it through.
Oh, so
I made it. Is there anybody in here that know that you made it?
We are not powerless. The Lord has given us great power. Think about this. The doctor has his scalpel. The mechanic has his tool. The fireman has his hose. What do we have? Well, among the many things that we have as believers, we have prayer. During this season of COVID-19, people are asking, what can we do? We can't go to the hospital. We can't go in. Listen, Let's stop talking about what we can't do, and let's start talking about what we can do, what we are able to do, what we have the power to do, the ability to do, what we have the authority to do. We have the authority to allow time and eternity to touch through prayer. Listen, I believe in God, and I believe in the tool He's given us called prayer. Let's go to God. Let's pray to Him. Pull up and pray. That's what I'm asking you to do. There are hospitals where sick people are. There are hospitals where people are dying. Yes, COVID-19, dying of that, and even beyond that. Listen, guess what we can do? We can pray. We can talk to God. We can call on Him as a healer. We can pray the prayer of faith. And the Bible says in James that He will heal and the sick will recover. Hey, God, join me pulling up to a hospital somewhere, wherever you are, on the way to work, on the way from work, on the way to the store. Just pull in, drive through if you have to. But whatever you do, pray.
Christ is risen. Oh, yes, He is risen indeed. And we can share and celebrate that on this Tuesday, August the 18th. Good morning, good afternoon. Welcome to all of you who've come together today for this purpose, for the purpose of prayer. I welcome you. Hey, I want you to like this video. I want you to comment on this video. Some of you have already done that. And I want you to share this video. Why? So we can make our prayer presence even larger on the World Wide Web, on Facebook, on YouTube. Hey, let's open the door. Let's make this room big. Listen, I want to say this, the more the merrier. When it comes to prayer, that is a true saying. That may not be true in every aspect of life. But when it comes to prayer, I believe when we are praying together, when we are praying on one accord, when we are praying in the Spirit, when we are praying to our God, man, wow, sisters, let's see what God is going to do. That's power, y'all. That's power in the room. Listen, how you feeling today? What is your I am statement? I am ready to pray. What is your I am statement for today? If you could also put that out there. And while you are typing that in, commenting on that, let me give you just a couple of announcements to think through. And remember, of course, we are still involved in our pull up and pray. I want to continue to push that. Go to a hospital, park there, pray there. Even if you cannot park, don't have that time, hey, roll through there and give God a breath prayer. Listen, we'll take it all. Large prayers, small prayers, long prayers, short prayers, whatever it is, we want to make sure that we are praying, if you will. We are still in our Bible reading. We are jaywalking, remember that? But now, watch this, we've crossed over from the smaller books that start with J to one of the larger books. We are now in Job chapter number 1. We've completed the smaller books that start with J, but we're going to do, I guess, a jaywalking part 2, if you will. Now we're looking at all of the books that start with J, and they are the larger books. And we start with Job chapter 1. So you should have read, or you are in the process of reading Job chapter 1 today as it relates to that. Hey, I'm still excited and still celebrating these 23 years. Thank God for these guest preachers that have come, that have shared. Pastor Ray Brown on August 16th, he shared. Pastor Kevin Nelson on the Sunday before that. Listen, we're having a wonderful time. Thank you for receiving these preachers that are coming to preach in my stead, as I am just worshiping and sharing with them, as you are as well. Lastly, don't let me forget this blood drive piece. I think I missed saying it on yesterday. Let me say it now. Listen, y'all, we are still a little shy of the numbers that we want to have. So I want you, if you will, I want you to just sign up, go to Facebook. The email that we sent out on Fridays, there's a link there. Sign up to be a part of our blood drive. Listen, there are people in need. As we feed people, as we clothe people, hey, this is another way that we can be missional This is another way that we can share and be a blessing to others. Listen, let's give blood, and you get something in return. You get the free testing as it relates to the COVID antibodies. So, hey, let's do that. Let's do what we can and share with others. Hey, we're praying today for leaders, political leaders particularly. I want to read from Judges chapter number 2, verse number 16. Matter of fact, this is one of our readings, the book of Judges, chapter number 2, verse number 16 in our jaywalking challenge. It says this: "Nevertheless, the Lord raised up judges who delivered them out of the land of those who plundered them." Hallelujah. Amen. We'll begin with the model prayer, the Lord's prayer, the disciples' prayer, and then we will go right into praying for our leaders today. Let's pray together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory, forever. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, thank you for being our Father. Thank you for being our heavenly Father, our heavenly parent. But Lord, even though we say you reside in heaven, we know you are right here with us on earth. Even closer than that, you are in our hearts. We bless you, Lord, for your continual presence in our lives. Lord, we have gathered together today. We like prayer, God. Yeah. We have gathered together today to expand and enlarge the prayer room. But Lord, we've gathered to ask, seek, and knock. We've gathered to seek your face, to stand before your throne, to bow before you. We've come, Lord, to petition you, even as we praise you, because you are God. Even as we praise you, you have been good, and you are always good to us. We worship you, Lord, because you were just so worthy. We've come, Lord, to petition today. Also, we've come to intercede today. Today, Lord, particularly on the behalf of our leaders at every level, our leaders in different facets of leadership, our political leaders particularly, especially them, that would mean in America our president and vice president and cabinet, that would mean our Congress, our senators, that would mean our judges, that would mean our governors, that would mean, Lord, our mayors, that would mean our council persons, aldermen, that would mean all of them who lead in different unions, if you will. Lord, we are praying for them. Lord, we read what you said in Judges, how you put leaders in place, even for protection. Lord, we know you put leaders in place for peace. You put leaders in place, and that is one of the means that you use even to provide. You have put leaders in place. And Lord, I know the position that you have ordained, the position that you have checked off, Lord, some in the position are not of you. Some in the position do not know you. Some in the position do not want to know you. Some in the positions have rejected you. But Lord, we thank you, though, for those in the positions that do know you, that love you, Lord, that are submitted to your will, that humble themselves under your mighty hand. We thank you for those, and we pray for all of them. For those that know you, God, we celebrate you and celebrate their faith, and we celebrate their trust and their hope. Pray, God, that they will stay focused. We know the enemy is always trying to distract us. He's always trying to also divide us. Ultimately, Lord, he's trying to destroy us. We pray, God, for their focus. We pray that they would stay focused on the purpose of honoring you, that your kingdom would come and your will would be done. As they lead these men, these women, as they lead in their different facets of leadership. God, be with them, God. Comfort them, God. Lord, we know every day won't be a victory over a battle, but we know that we've already won the war. And God, I pray for their encouragement. Lord, I know as a leader myself, I know many on this line that are leaders, we know how easy it is to get discouraged, how easy it is to get tired, how easy it is to grow weary. But I remember your word saying, do not grow weary in doing well. Help us to remember that we will reap if we do not faint. We will reap. It is worth it. We will reap payday someday. We will reap if we do not fail, if we do not give up. So I pray this for these leaders, that they will not fail. They will not faint. They will not give up. They will not turn back. They will not lay down and die, but stand strong for the cause. And I pray, God, for the other leaders that do not know you, do not care about you, have rejected you. I pray for their salvation, number one. Yeah. Yeah, I pray for their salvation. I pray for their growth, Lord. I pray for their maturity, Father, in the name of Jesus. I pray that they would come asking, what must I do to be saved? And we can tell them, you already paid the price. You did the work. Accept Jesus Christ. Let him be your Lord. Let him be your Savior. Believe that Jesus lived and died and was resurrected on Sunday. But Lord, I just pray their salvation, their deliverance, that they would maybe become a part of the regiment of the redeemed, baptized in the Spirit and baptized by water. I pray for them, Lord, for even for those who will not receive you, who will be in a constant state of rejection, I still pray that your strong hand will be over their lives and that we would live a peaceable life. In Jesus' name, we pray for them, God. Hold them and keep them. There are, I know, still pharaohs in certain positions who will harden their heart against you, God, who will not follow you, who will not believe you, who will put burdens on the people. I pray for them as well. And Lord, if I'm praying for the leadership, I guess I should also pray for all of us in our levels and places of fellowship. May we follow, God, those things that will honor you, those things that will bless you, those things that will advance the kingdom. But may we stand up against those things that are against your will and in against your way, in Jesus' name. So, Lord, I pray for this world. I pray for our country, the United States of America. I pray, Lord, for the state that I am in, Texas. I pray for the county that I reside in and this church resides in, Bear County. I pray for the city of San Antonio, Kirby, in Jesus' name. Lord, I turn my attention now to just praying for these prayer warriors, these prayer partners that are with me now, praying right now. God, give them strength. Keep them focused. Energize them, Lord. Keep warming them fervently. Give them passion, God, as we go forth to pray, to change situations, change predicaments, change atmospheres, change the hearts of all without and those within. In Jesus' name, hallelujah, amen. Saints, I haven't told you this in a minute, but let me just let you know how, wow, encouraged I am having you with me to pray on these days that we pray. Don't forget, listen, about our Lunch with the Lord service on tomorrow, 12 noon. And of course, our Bible study at 7 o'clock tomorrow on Wednesday. Hey, thank you for praying with me. I love you. I am very, very, very strengthened by it. Hey, hugs, kisses to you all. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Has he done anything for you? Come on, everybody, put your hands.